So it's 2017 and we're still talking about pretty printing. I'm a little disappointed, but you know, you have to do what you have to do. Okay, so pretty printing, by the laughs, I guess most people know what it is. Just to make sure, so here is an example. Well, we throw in an S expression in this case, and it should the program should put it in a way which reveals the structure, so that when you look at it, you're not, you know, let's say, yeah. If it were to look like this, or like so, that would be bad. No. Okay. So, okay, so it's not so easy to do pretty printing. and if you have typeset papers, I suspect many of you have, since they are academics. So it's difficult because every character, or at least every line counts. If you do a little change at the beginning, can have a huge effect in the bottom. So it's not really the case that you can have a greedy algorithm in the sense that you only look at the current line or at a local scope and make the best decision for what's coming later on. We will see what happens later. Okay, so let's assume that we have a type like so for S expressions, for those who know Haskell notations. And we're going to say that we can either typeset them or pretty print them horizontally, like so here, or vertically, like so. Okay. And so if we look at the state, it's not quite the state of the art, but this is what most people know, or at least in the context of Perls, people talk about a huge pretty printing library, and it's still being used today. So if we print the expression that you saw before on 20 columns with huge library, it looks like so. Okay. So at first it works well, and then something goes wrong there. So what's happening is it tries to be greedy. It figures out that the A fits down the line, but you can't put the whole thing. So it cannot be put, this ABCD there cannot be put horizontally, and so you end up with this situation here, and so on for the rest, and I wouldn't say it's so pretty. So I think we should probably keep going. So, Phil Wadler came up with a prettier printer, okay? His words. a prettier printer. His solution, I mean, it works well in this case, but here we waste one line, if you see, because there is actually enough space to put the thing here. But with his library, you cannot express this construction. You cannot put a document on the right hand side of another document. You can only have constant amount of indentation. So again, I kept searching and I didn't find anything. I had to write my own library. And so here am I. Okay, so I really wanted that you've seen in the title slide. Title page. Okay, so a problem, of course, especially when you write this for a program committee, is you have to be really clear what you're talking about. So I could not just say, well, I want to save one line here and there. So I think one contribution is to actually try to pinpoint, first informally, what a pretty printer is. Okay, so if you know the laws of robotics, I wrote them in this. I wrote the laws of pretty printing in this style. Pretty printer shall not print beyond the right margin. Okay, so you have to see everything on the page. A pretty printer shall reveal the structure of the input. That's a little problematic. We're going to see what happens in a second. And lastly, a pretty printer shall use as few lines as possible. And there is priority, so first you fit on the page, then you reveal the structure of the input, and finally you optimize the length. We've seen that use library breaks the third law, and Wadler's library breaks the second. Right, because I don't think that this reveals well the structure of the input. And well, in the paper there is maybe a more convincing example. But at least it's actually also wasting lines here and there. And so in the paper or in this contribution, I'm trading performance in exchange for abiding to these laws. Problem is rule two. What is it to reveal the structure? And here I use the DSL technique. You let the user, you give the user a suitable DSL and you let them explain what they want. And here is the API I give them. You can embed the string. Okay, not so surprising. You can have horizontal concatenation, and I'm going to explain in a second what that means. You can add an empty line at the end, and you have this junction between two layouts. So you have two possibilities to reveal the structure, and the library should pick the best one. Using this API, we can express the pretty printer for S expressions succinctly, like so. I think here is the important part. So we have, we can either lay out horizontally or vertically. Yeah. So this is the semantics for the API. Without this junction. So perhaps we don't care about this really. So we can embed text, okay, trivially. Oh, first I should say, what's the layout? A list of strings, okay, what we want to print. So we print them, if we render the layout, we should put new lines in between. Embed. Horizontal concatenation, okay, that looks a little complicated. I want you to read that. And then, read it if you're super clever. And so adding an empty line, okay. So this is what horizontal concatenation does. So if you have two layouts, the first layout is represented by X's up here, and the second layout is represented by Y's. We want to aboot the second layout against the last character of the last line of the first layout. Okay, so this is what it looks like, on an example. Here is the code that does that. Now this junction, we can implement that by doing idiomatic distribution over sets. Yeah, so a disjunction is represented by a set of possible layouts, and we do combinatorial search. Okay, so that's a beginning, and it works, except that it's totally unacceptable performance-wise, because every choice introduces two layouts, and if you have 20 disjunctions, then you have two to the power of 20 choices, and this is never going to finish. So how do we turn this specification, essentially, into a usable pretty printing library? Firstly, we should look only at what matters, namely three parameters. So a layout, from the point of view of pretty printing, is characterized by a width and height and the width of the last line here. Okay. So it doesn't matter if this line here has a space here, Okay. That's irrelevant for purpose of the pretty printing algorithm. So why can we do that? Because the horizontal concatenation has the property that the parameters of the result depend only on the parameters of the input. So here is graphically how you compute the parameters. I'm pretty proud of this. It took me a while to typeset. And the second thing is, we discard dominated layouts. So what is it? What is domination? Well, a layout A dominates a layout B if and only if A is smaller than B in all three dimensions. And the consequence of this is that whenever you, for any given context, if you splice in A, then the result of splicing A will dominate also the result of splicing B. And thus, we can always, at any point, discard all dominated results. Okay, so intuitively, that makes sense if you look at this picture here, because if we make anything, if we make all three dimensions smaller, there's no way that we are going to get a bigger thing on the right-hand side. Okay. And so, okay, look at the paper for the proof. Okay, that's those who like little proofs about programs, they will enjoy it. And only with this optimization you get quite good results. So, okay, so that's a linear relationship. It's on a log-log graph, so maybe it takes a while to get convinced, but I wrote the linear asymptote here for your convenience. So yeah, you get this linear relationship. So this graph is obtained by exhausting balanced graphs, balanced trees represented as S expressions, pretty printing them, and this is what you get. Reviewers were not convinced, and they wanted me to do it on random. So obviously that works, but okay. This is what you get, yeah. So I would say it's good. So even though I didn't care about absolute performance, I cared only about asymptotic, the absolute performance is acceptable. So it's about 10 times as slow as the Wadler library with Dan Lyons implementation. Okay, can probably do better, but in any case, for most purposes, it's good. Okay, let's conclude. So here, what I wanted to do is to do a programming Perl, not just, you know, a specification that comes from heavens and then program calculation steps. I try to be a little more like what you would do in reality. So define informally a specification, look at the difficult parts, prove those, even use graphical models. Not throwing out program calculation. I mean, everything is proved. Well, okay. The non-trivial parts are proved in the paper. So the take-home message is, okay, you cannot be pretty, as I define it, and greedy, but still, you can be fast enough. In the paper, you will see all the proof steps. I'm sure you love proof steps and typesetting slightly better. Thanks for your attention.